Hi guys, welcome to this tutorial. It's teacher Raya here. So in this session we're going to solve question 12 B and C from the NECTA Form 4 Mathematics paper 2020. I have already completed part A, is in a separate video because it was a long question, so I decided to do that part separately. Okay, so we are told the following figure represent a rectangular prism in which PQ is 12, QR is 8, and RY is 4 centimeters. We're asked to find the total surface area of this prism, and then we're asked to find the angle between the planes PTZW and QRZW. So let's start with. So the surface area basically is just the area of the surfaces of this prism. All the surfaces are rectangles, so all we have to do is just add them up. Now, because it's a rectangle, we're going to have three shapes which are the same. So we've got one here is the same to this one, and then that shape is the same as this shape, and then we have the top, this one, and the bottom shape, which is going to be the same shape. So all I'm going to do is just find three of them and then double it. Okay, so the total surface area is going to be the double of, if I take the front side, that's going to be 12 times 4. So that's 4. 12 times 4 plus, and then I can take the side, which is going to be 8 times 4. And now I'm going to add the what I'm going to add now, the top and bottom. So the area for that one is going to be 8 centimeters times 12 centimeters. Okay, so 8 times 12, guys. If you add all this up, guys, I'm going to let you calculate. So that's going to be equal to 352 centimeters squared. So guys, now for part II, we are asked to find the angle between the planes PTZW. So what is that plane? So it's going to be this surface over here, PTZW. Imagine this is a wall, okay? So it's going to be this wall here. And then the plane QRZW. Now where is that? Well, that wall or that plane, you can think of it as a wall, is hanging. So let's just draw that wall in. QR, so that's going to be from there to there. Z, and that's going to be connecting there. And then W is going to be here. So imagine this is a roof, or you could think of a book inside a box, and it's sitting like this. Okay, so we're going to draw that in. Okay, so now we have our two planes identified. We have that, imagine that's a wall, and you can imagine that's like a roof or something inside a building. And you can see they are meeting at these points here, and these is going to the bottom of a room of some sort. Okay, so what we need to find is the angle between these two planes. So the angle between them is going to be this one here. Okay, because it's PTZW, which is this one here, and QRZW, which is this yellow one here. Now, I'm going to draw this triangle out here because it does make a triangle. Now this is our yellow plane. So what do we have here? I'm going to take this corner W, and then I'm going to take this corner Q. Now because this is a rectangular prism, this point at P you have a 90 degrees. Now we know PW is going to be the same as YR, which is 4 centimeters. PQ we know is 12 centimeters. What we need is this angle here. So what can we do? Well, we got the opposite of that angle and we got the adjacent of that angle, so we can take tan of that. So if we say tan PWQ, that's going to be equal to the opposite of adjacent 12 over 4 guys, and that's going to be equal to 3. So therefore angle PW is going to be the tan inverse of 3. Guys, if you work this out, then you will have 71.57 degrees correct to 2 decimal places. Okay, so hopefully this was okay, guys. And now for part C, we are asked to calculate the volume of a cone whose base radius is 12 centimeters, so it's a cone, and slant height is 20 centimeters. And we're asked to use pi as 3.14. So let's just draw. Whenever you do geometry questions, just make sure you draw, okay? Do a little sketch. It doesn't have to be a very good sketch. We are not artists, we are mathematicians. So if you have a cone, the bottom of it, the base of the cone, is going to be a circle. So, and we are told the radius of that is 12. So the circle has a center and the radius of this is 12 centimeters. We are also told the slant height. The slant is this side, which is like half an angle, is leaning. In other words, they are not the vertical height of the cone. So we know this is going to be 20 centimeters and this side is going to be 20 centimeters. Now, how can we find the volume of a cone? So let's put in our formula. So the volume of a cone is given as what? Area of this circle, which is going to be pi r squared times 1/3 of the vertical height. Okay, so let's just put that in. Vertical height of the cone is this one, okay? So that makes 90 degrees to the center of the base, right? This is the height that we need. So the area of the circle, okay, times 1/3 of the vertical height. So that's going to be h over 3. 1/3 means you divide something by 3. Now, where is our problem? The problem is we don't have the vertical height. We have the slanted side, okay? But what can we do? We have here a right angle. Now let's take this triangle out. I'm going to talk about this triangle. I'm going to draw it right here. Okay, guys? So I have a 90 degrees there and I'm going to take this line, which is this one, 12 centimeters, and I know the slanted side is 20 centimeters. And now this is my height. What can I use, guys, to find the vertical height? It is a right angled triangle. So we can use the Pythagoras theorem. So guys, you know, if you do 20 squared is going to be equal to h squared plus 12 squared. So guys, to get h, you need to square root on both sides. So you're going to get square root of 20 squared minus 12 squared. This is going to be equal to square of 20 is 400. take where square of 12 is 144. So this is going to give you the square root. 400 take away 144 is 256, which is going to be equal to 16. Guys, I hope you know how to work thirds out. So now we have our vertical height, then we can find a volume. So let's use a different color. Volume is going to be equal to the circle of this cone, so pi, which we're told to use 3.14. So I'm going to use 3.14 times r squared. The radius of this circle is 12. So 12 squared times the vertical height, which you now know is 16. Everything divided by this 3. All right, guys, if you work this out, then you will get answer as 2411.52 centimeters cubed. And I hope you know how to multiply. Thank you for watching, guys, and bye for now.